first time ago, an American airplane...
A stone's throw away from the Utah-Nevada border sits several unobtrusive hangars and buildings besides a runway covered in dust.
This is where those crews were. This is where the men trained.
One might never know by looking at it today, but 75 years ago, this base was at the center of the world stage.
We have now added a new and revolutionary increase.
And worked for those many months to do the most important mission in the world.
Wendover Army Air Base still stands today as the place where those atomic missions got their start.
It's something that's a part of history. It's something that took place here in Wendover.
The director of the museum, Jim Peterson, knows all the stories. Under the command of Colonel Paul Tibbetts, the secret operation started from scratch, from the design of the bombs themselves to the development of the 15 B-29 superfortresses that flew the missions, including the most iconic, the Enola Gay.
None of the atomic mission planes had any nose art. The day before the mission, Colonel Tibbetts chose which plane he was going to use, and he told one of the airmen, go out and paint the words Enola Gay on that plane. Enola Gay is Tibbetts' mother.
The artifacts are a sight to see.
It's the most original remaining Army Air Force base in the country.
And those memories still have an amazing presence here.
This is the hangar that the Enola Gay and 14 other atomic mission aircraft were serviced, retrofitted, and prepared. Everywhere you look, this place has so much history, and the walls are alive with the importance of those days.
It's a place that is like no other. You can feel the walls talking to you.
And it's a place that's very special to Stephen Marquardt, whose father flew one of the B-29s on both missions.
He was an eyewitness to the event that happened 75 years ago today. His plane was pointed directly at Hiroshima. This is part of my dad's life, a big part of it. He met my mother in Salt Lake when he trained here.
The base is stellar, but it wasn't always this way.
When I came out here in 2000, the place was a complete junkyard.
And for Peterson, all this hard work is for those who came before.
The sacrifices of our veterans, it's something that as the generations get further from that time, that needs to not get lost.
And with a place like this, those memories from 75 years ago will hopefully never be lost. In Wendover, Spencer Joseph, Fox 13 News, Utah.